Welcome back, everyone. I'm Allison Berman. Right now, I'm sitting here with Rob Nail. Rob Nail is an associate founder and CEO of Singularity University. He's also formerly the founder and CEO of Velocity 11 and a roboticist by training and passion still. Welcome, Rob.
Thank you so much. I'm glad to be here.
Yeah, we're super happy to have you here.
It's awesome.
So one thing at Singularity University's Global Summit that's really powerful is our network from all around the world comes together. And there's just this really interesting feeling and energy here. Can you talk to me a bit about this unique power of the Singularity University Global Network?
It's one of these amazing things where we've always had this belief that you bring a diverse group of people together, you look at some of the most powerful forces, specifically technology and the opportunities implications, and you get them to ideate and think about bigger and bigger challenges. And then you just see what happens. Mm-hmm. And you know, it's a good theory.
Yeah.
But it turns out that it's amazing and far more things you could ever imagine actually happen. And I mean, you can just see the crazy vibe that's behind us here.
Completely.
We have like 1,600 people from 64 countries. 64 countries in this room. And an overwhelming majority of people from out of the US, which creates a very different sort of dynamic with, mm-hmm. with the community. And everyone's very passionate about technology, about the future, and wanting to truly make a difference.
Yeah.
And so I could not be more excited and proud of like what we've done, even just with this Global Summit event, because it really does show that by bringing these diverse groups of people, uniting them on sort of common themes and common problems like the Global Grand Challenges, mm-hmm. what naturally occurs are uncommon partnerships, right? We get these startups connecting with these nonprofits, connecting with these corporates, and you got government ministers from all over the world wanting to support and bring those things back.
Yeah.
It's amazing. I'd love to say that we have this machine that just cranks that out, but a little bit of just setting the stage.
Yeah, and allowing it to happen.
Yeah.
Is there an example of one of those magical, uncommon partnerships that you can tell me about?
Wow.
I can think of one of my favorites.
I'm sure there are so many. In fact, there's like so many that I don't even know about. That's the one that's maybe more exciting. One of the things that we did recently was in our last impact report that we publish mm-hmm. every year because we're a benefit corp.
Yeah.
We try to characterize the number of impact initiatives that are taking place around the world. So these are projects, startups, policy initiatives that we believe will make a big difference in society, tackling grand challenges, or really unique to leveraging technology. And the way that we found them was we relentlessly solicited through surveys our community, like what projects are you working on, what can make a difference?
Yeah.
And we were hoping to get at least 1,000 things identified, because we know there's a lot.
Yeah.
And we got 4,644 reported. And I've tested this a few times now just at the summit, and in our alumni meeting yesterday, mm-hmm. I think we had like 160 alumni from around the world that were at the morning session. And I polled them how many of them actually reported on an initiative that they were working on that reported to our impact report. And there were 5 hands out of the 160
goodness.
People.
So some of our active alumni weren't even captured in that huge report.
And then I asked how many of them are actually working on a project or an initiative today that they think is going to be impactful to the grand challenges or others. And we had like 80 hands raised. So we're not even remotely capturing the mm-hmm. number of projects that our community is taking away and taking out into the world. So the numbers just from that standpoint are staggering in terms of the number of things that we're helping spark and catalyze and supporting many. I'd love to hear which one that you're excited about.
One of my favorite ones is just when I talk to Kyle Nell with Lowe's Innovation, and they sync up with Made in Space, that's doing zero-G 3D printing on the International Space Station.
Yeah, crazy.
It's crazy. It's perfect.
Yeah. So you can buy a wrench from Lowe's in space that will be printed on site. It's crazy.
It's great. And I think they talk a lot about the practical application, yeah. but I also think how special would it be if, you know, your husband or wife who's on Earth gets to send you a little custom thing that gets printed. It's a way that you're really connecting with a loved one at such a distance. Yeah. I think that could be amazing.
Totally. Incredible. Yeah, there's, God, I can't, you put me on the spot. There's like so many to choose from. One of the things that we learned about last year at the summit was we had two folks come to an EP 2 years ago. Maybe it was 2.5 years ago, and the exec program, the week-long exec program. We had an exec from Cisco and a media marketing business guy. They were really inspired by tech and sort of the program they had and the connection to the Grand Challenges. And they lived in Germany at the time, and they went back, and in Germany, in Berlin specifically, you know, there's a big refugee challenge. Germany has been a leader in bringing in refugees from the various conflict zones in the world, and there's a huge refugee camp in Berlin that is supporting, you know, tens of thousands of people, and they see this as an amazing thing for the community to do, but it's disconnected from the community. The community doesn't know how to support it, and so very quickly they just ideated, in fact, at the exec program, about what a low cost solution could be to help some of the specific problems in the refugee camp, and specifically around access to medical information and issues. And so they just like whipped up this idea for a container, like a cargo ship container, which are cheap and standard, and equip it with standard like Cisco connectivity equipment, and make it a med center. And so instantly they just like got a couple $1,000s. They built one. Cisco helped put all the stuff in it, and they dropped it into a refugee camp. And so what happens is they have a computer screen connectivity, and someone can come in and they connect to a whole network of doctors that can interact instantly from anywhere in the world. And so now you have virtually free medical consultation happening on site at a refugee camp. And so they ended up raising a little bit of money to do, in fact, through the SU community to build 10 more of these. And it's just like such a simple, easy idea that all it takes is somebody with the passion to engage and do it and make it happen.
Yeah.
And what you'll find is the SU community is uniquely excited to support those ideas.
Yeah.
We just have to know about them, right? So
yeah.
So to the degree that somebody has an amazing idea or project that could be a model for the future that we can share out to the world, or we should be supporting or bringing into our accelerator program or bringing to in front of government or corporate opportunities, like we just need to hear about them, and then we'll get which there's a bunch of them here today, right?
Yeah.
We've got a bunch of great projects that we're demoing.
What's exciting about what you're saying is I think it's the mobilization of resources and people.
Yeah.
And so sometimes there's a big problem, but people don't know where to begin.
Right.
And hearing that, it's really inspiring seeing how it comes together and then it scales, and it's just an amazing way to drive impact.
Yeah, definitely.
So I want to ask you about Singularity University. You know, we're at the intersection of we have to balance market demands and making impact.
Right.
And it's really a new model of business. I think it relates to what Peter D says about abundance thinking, making things abundant. How do we balance this?
Yeah. Great question. So this is an interesting tension that we face all the time. We talk about it quite a bit at the organization. We're a benefit corporation.
Yeah.
SU was actually founded as a 501c3, a nonprofit, and then we converted it in 2012 into a benefit corp, largely because the nonprofit structure is not necessarily a sustainable structure. It's very hard to, you can't be profitable. It's hard to have startup equity and building things. And the model of nonprofits is typically you just keep getting money donated to you to keep going, which is not a sustainable model.
No.
Versus the for-profit C-Corp structure, which really the board only responsibility is to the financial interest of the shareholders, which means you could do horrible things to the world, the environment, and still make money for the shareholders.
Yeah.
Which I think kind of got us into some of the problems that we're facing today in the world, globally, right? And so the idea of a benefit corp is you got to own both of those. You have to have a mission that is going to do good for the world, and you should have the flexibility of making money, being sustainable, growing, and benefit of paying taxes also. is a natural balance. I think every organization has that tension.
Yeah.
It's just with being a benefit corp, we're very explicit about where we draw the lines and how we do it, and we have the opportunity to make decisions very clearly at the board level of our mission and the shareholders and the growth. So
yeah.
So I like that tension being explicit.
Yeah.
We report on it. We try to do a lot of things to make it very clear. In terms of how we manage the business day to day, for me, the most important thing is we're trying to create a model for our business that is sustainable, that allows us to make money, and if we do it really, really well, we make a great impact in the world,
yeah.
Right? So the more money we make is only a reflection of how much impact we're making in the world.
Mm-hmm.
And that model's not perfect, and we're still working on it, but we are working on a lot of very specific corporate programs, connecting them to the global grand challenges as big business opportunities, where that shows where we can get corporations to pay us to find big opportunities for their business to grow, but are also solving the world's biggest problems.
Exactly.
It's a perfect fit. It's a beautiful synergy.
It is, and I think that tension of purpose, impact, accountability, it's what drives innovation as well.
Absolutely, and I think that's what this whole community really is about.